This is wrong. This is right. If you're doing this, you're wrong. Here's why. All right, knuckleheads. So we have a lot of people out there that have this whole debate that say you shouldn't be using E and I. Stop using that. It's so stupid. Just use V and A when you're talking about voltage and amperage. Like, why use an E and an I? All the textbooks have it. Everything you look in, like, engineering and, you know, all these people, there is a mix. Some of them use V, some of them use I, some of them use E, some of them use A. So why do we care and should you care? So here's the deal. This is wrong. This is right. And I'm going to tell you why. So voltage. The reason that we don't say V for voltage, voltage is a measurement of something. We measure in volts, but what we're measuring is a thing called potential difference, or we can even say we're measuring EMF. We're measuring an electromotive force, and how much force there is measured in volts, which is why we say we're measuring EMF. We're not measuring volts. You can't measure volts. Volts is the measurement itself, right? It's like saying we're measuring length in inches. We're not measuring inches, we're measuring length, and we're measuring it in inches. So we always represent length when we're doing something as L. And then we say, what is the length? It's 20 inches. So this is not right. Voltage as a word doesn't actually mean anything. It's potential difference and it's measured in volts. Same thing for amperage. There is no word amperage. This is just a word that we say out in the field. Does anybody care? No, it's fine. You can use it. I use amperage. I use voltage all the time. But to be specific in why we're using E and I, amperage is not a word. It's a rate of flow of charges through a conductor that we are measuring. And when we take a measurement of the thing, that intensity of flow, we're measuring that in amps. It's a number of coulombs per second is an ampere. So amperes is the measurement. Flow of charges is what we're trying to measure. So we use E for voltage. We use I for amperage. I is measured in A. E is measured in V. You can't have V measured in V and A measured in A. That's just an inaccuracy. Now, where we do get it right is the other ones that we use. So we use resistance. We use R. This is good. This checks off. We're measuring a thing called resistance, which is in opposition to current flow, and it is measured in ohms. We don't say V equals A times ohm. That's the right way to do it. If you're going to do this, if you're going to like go against actual like logic and use V and A, then you need to use ohm, because we're measuring something in volts, measuring something in amps, measuring something in ohms. Otherwise, you have to use E equals I times R. The thing I'm measuring, and for each of those, we're measured in volts, we're measured in amps, and we're measured in ohms. So if you hope you can kind of understand what the difference is, it's like speaking accurately or kind of just knuckle dragging your way through a conversation. Same thing with power. Power, we get it right? We use P for power. We are measuring power. Power is a rate of energy transfer per second. Specifically, it's how many joules of energy is transferred every single second in a constant power situation. And it's measured in watts. So we wouldn't say for watts, we wouldn't say a VA equals W. Unless we're trying to say that a volt amp equals a watt. But when we're trying to do a calculation, we don't write this. We write P equals E times I. Because we're measuring the power, the rate of energy transfer should be whatever the rate of charges flowing through a circuit is at whatever times whatever electromotive force is causing that to happen. And the measurement of those things is in the volt, the amp, and the watt. So again, make sure that you're keeping the thing you're measuring and what that actual measurement is the same. And the way that I think about this is like when we say like a car's going a certain miles per hour, right? Miles per hour is the measurement. It's going 60 miles an hour, but we're not actually measuring these miles per hour thingies everywhere. We're measuring velocity. How fast is a car going? That's the thing we're measuring. So we use V to represent how fast is the thing going. V is measured in miles per hour. We wouldn't have a formula that looks like this, like we're gonna figure out how many miles per hour things are equal to how many feet times second things. No, we say what is the velocity, what's the speed? And that speed should be whatever the distance that's being traveled times the time that it takes to travel. That's gonna give us a certain velocity, and that velocity is measured in miles per hour. The distance is measured in feet, or it can be measured in meters or kilometers, right? So all of these different units of measure are different ways, but the actual thing being measured is the distance, the time, and the velocity. And that's why the actual thing being measured is EMF times a rate of current flow through a resistance. And so we use the volt to give us the quantity of EMF. The ampere is the quantity of charge flow, and the ohm, the right thing that you should be using here if you're gonna do this crazy weird stuff, is the measure of how much opposition to resistance. Now, final thought, does it actually matter? No. Does it matter that you call a plug, even though a plug is the thing you plug into a receptacle? A receptacle receives, plugs plug in. No, but you're out there just calling them plugs all day long. So it's just kind of like, how accurate do you want to be? You know, when you're looking through code, code's a very accurate place to hang out, right? They're talking about equipment grounding conductors and utilization equipment. And it's like, why all these crazy words? Well, it's because it like at a certain level of like professionalism, of specificity, you actually want to be accurate. And so in a code environment, being accurate is really, really important. You and your knucklehead friends wiring a house together? No, dude, none of this stuff matters. As long as you understand that if you're the one in the comments saying, yo, you should be using V and I, you're actually the one that's not right. And there's a scientific reason. When you get into science and physics, this is the realm they live in, where these things matter, the actual units of measure and quantities that are being measured. You don't ever represent them as the same thing. So that's why, is anybody gonna kill you for it? No, except for Facebook warriors that have their opinions in Facebook. But just remember, Facebook's not a real place. Love you people. I'll see you in the next one.